No, like I don't tend to adjust my opinions to make sure that people are like, oh, that this is, you know.
You don't put your answers in a politically correct way.
No.
So, Lindsay asks, I have a question. Are there more than two genders?
I was wondering if we're gonna get to this.
Yeah.
Okay, so
Yes,
my
in terms of we are going to get to it. Do you want to answer first, or would you like me to?
No, I'll answer.
Go ahead.
Okay, so if we're talking purely biological, no, there are no more than two genders. Anyone who's like, there are biologically there are more than two genders, it's like, no, that's not true. That's stupid. Stop being stupid. If you want to be like, are
Well,
people?
are we making a distinction between gender and sexes?
Well, that's why I'm saying biologically.
Okay.
So biologically, there are no more than two genders or sexes.
And there's
If you,
XX and XY,
yeah,
yes.
if you want to get into like, are people allowed to say, I'm a dragonkin or I'm a asexual toaster? Then do whatever you fucking want. I don't care. That's my take on it. You know, if you want me to validate your life by being like going out and campaigning for your rights and things like that, like yeah, I'll be like, yes, you should have your rights. You should be able to, you know, be who you want and say what you want and blah 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 blah. If you then insist that there's laws to make me conform to your beliefs or anything like that, you can go fuck yourselves.
I think I generally agree
Yeah.
as far as it goes. I think when it comes down to it really shouldn't matter
Oh, it
what
shouldn't matter, but you
gender
know.
someone is or what they want to call themselves. In the sense that, at least in America,
America.
we have this whole Constitution thing. That says, yeah, life, liberty, pursuit of happiness. All right, nowhere in that does that say I need to be concerned about what you got in your bits.
Yep.
Like I don't care. As long as everybody has equal protection under the law, I'm good. And if you want to be a demi boy, if the gender you feel you are does not match the gender you were born with, I don't really care. Because as far as it goes, claiming to be, and the biggest argument against people defining themselves by other genders seems to be based in the bathroom bits.
Yeah.
Well, what if a man decides he's a woman and goes into the woman's restroom? He's a prevert. Well, here's the deal. If a man decides he is a woman, or a man decides she's a woman, whatever, I'm not gonna worry about pronouns in the theoretical discussion here.
Yep.
And uses the restroom and leaves? Congratulations, no problem. If that person starts peeking under the stall and looking
And
at your bits, then they've broken the law, and it doesn't matter what goddamn gender they are. Being a different gender
oh,
doesn't make you a prevert or a lawbreaker.
do you want to know? Do you want to know like something that I found really funny?
Go ahead.
Do you know Lauren Southern?
The name doesn't sound familiar.
She was a journalist, or she is a journalist for like a kind of, you know, what's it called? Breitbart, I think. No, the Rebel. Yeah. Anyway, she was like liberals don't like her because she's Republican, she's a Trump supporter, you know, blah blah blah. She was at a
Oh, he's on a, sorry, he's your guy is on a little horsey thing.
boy, yeah.
Yeah, nice.
It's not Grimgore though.
Yeah, I know it's not Grimgore.
Yeah.
I saw that because his name was different.
Ah.
Still, cool. Sorry, continue.
But yeah, she got assaulted by I think it was a guy who is actually a girl. So I don't know, fucking, you know, you know what I mean, like, born a man is now a woman. So she
identifies as a woman.
Yeah, sure. So she was assaulted by this woman, and a little bit later she was also assaulted by a man who used to be a woman. The man who used to be a woman was like taken to court and all this kind of thing, and when they got to court, he went as a woman.
Okay.
So he was basically like, I want to be tried as a woman.
Okay, which shouldn't matter.
No. It shouldn't matter. But the thing that makes me laugh about this is, like, you know, they're like, oh, the patriarchy, like, because this person's a feminist, you know, like, very, very vitriolic feminist, very aggressive feminist, you know, like, oh, the patriarchy and all that. How is it possible that in a system where the patriarchy rules, where men have everything better, why would you choose to be a woman when it comes to the justice system?
Generally speaking, because that's one of the weird things about it, is the general concept is the patriarchy, whatever that word is.
The patriarchy!
As weak and frail and need to be protected, thus they generally don't get as harsh punishments. It's why there aren't very many women that get death row, even though they do some pretty heinous shit.
Yeah. No, I'm just saying, you know, like, I'm on board with that. I agree with that. It's just, I find it funny because, you know, like, the second the situation is, let's say, personal, you know, like, it, you know, it suddenly, the rhetoric dies away and it's like, oh, this is going to be bad for me, maybe, so I should probably, you know, I should probably strap my vagina on.
Patriarchy, the thing the dark elves don't do.
Yeah, they don't do that.
Nice.
But anyway, yeah, like, I just found that interesting. Like, the thing is, like, whenever you...
Go ahead.
Crap.
Sorry.
The thing, well...
asking why these guys haven't broken yet.
Yeah, they're dwarves. They have quite high leadership. The thing is, like, when I say these things, people get really defensive, and they're like, well, men do this and men do that. I'm like, I'm not arguing... you know, I'm not arguing in kind of like in favor of men or against women. I'm just saying it's fucking funny to see these things. You know, so like people...
Humans are silly. I mean...
Yeah. Humans are silly and they do silly things and it amuses me. So, you know, when I see a man, like, you know, strip naked and be like, all women are evil, I'm going to laugh at him just as much as I laugh at the pussy hat parade, which was maybe...
My general concept is this, and I think this is something that most humans do and is very foolish.
Yeah.
Across the board. They see one person in a group do an activity.
Yeah.
And so that one person in the group does an activity, so they then prescribe that action to the rest of that group that person belongs to.
Mm.
So a man goes and beats up a man who is born a woman, and so, but is I'm a man now, beats up another person or does something perverted or whatever. It doesn't really matter what it is so much for my point.
I mean, it always matters when it's something perverted.
Always. But essentially, so that happens, and it's reported in the news, and then all of a sudden, everybody who is against that cause goes, oh, well, that happened because they're this, so all of the people that do this are preverts or violent. It's like, no, that person individually had this problem and did this thing. It had nothing to do with the entire group that they were part of. Unless that group calls for violence against people or perverse actions against people as, like, its stated goal, it's probably not a group thing. It's a person thing. So I know it's easier to lump people into groups and then assume things about those groups. It's easier to put that into a mental box and to deal with it. It's just a terrible way of thinking.
Honestly, I kind of maintain that
hold on, I do need to... Big boy Elroy, no, I will not shave on stream, but thank you for coming by. Pickle, come for the battle, stay for the thought-provoking conversation. Apparently, we have thought-provoking conversations.
I love having, like, really difficult conversations. You know, like talking about really kind of, really, like, stuff people refuse to touch on stream and on video. Because at the end of the day, you know, if you're too scared to talk about something, then it probably needs to be talked about.
I would not be opposed to doing a series of videos with you where we just do a talk show style shit about horrendous, horrendously difficult subjects to talk about.
Hell yeah.
On YouTube, because I don't want to get banned on Twitch.
I swear I am partially on a campaign to get banned off Twitch.
Though, I mean, to be entirely honest, I would like to do it on Twitch if I could, because then we would be able to talk to the audience.
I mean, you can do it on IRL, probably. Maybe not. Like, they're really weird about that stuff, I think.
They really are.
Like, because the rules are so vague, it's just like, you have to talk to your stream, and it's like, okay, so... Well,
and we would be talking to the stream, but only, like, in a sense, like, they would be asking questions.
I mean, you could do chat show, but then... I mean, the chat show would probably, or talk show, it would probably be valid, but, you know, like, I could easily, YouTube is currently going through some issues, basically, where it's like, anyone who talks about problematic stuff will be shadow banned because, you know, we're losing our advertisers. Because there's basically a campaign by the media against YouTube right now. Which I find fucking hilarious. Even though it's not my livelihood and I'm probably going to be fucked from this, I find it hilarious that, like, the proper old school media is now going ham on YouTube, basically being like, no, don't let them do this. This is problematic. We need condominiums.
Sheep, there's a gentleman in my chat who really wants to see an individual shave themselves on stream. So
well, big boy Elroy.
Yeah, big boy Elroy.
I'll tell you what, big boy.
Start your stream and shave.
No, no, because I don't do anything anyone who watches me wants me to do, by definition. Oh God.
Oh Jesus.
May want to run.
Yeah, you think? Sheebug! They just came out of the goddamn woodwork! Holy crap, yeah, run!
Poor Spanish fan.
That did not get better!
Yeah, okay, big boy Elroy, I'll tell you what, if you personally donate... £1,000 to both me and Yujoon, I will shave my beard.
Pretty sure we can't win this fight, Miamigo.
Yeah, give it a try.
Okay.
I mean, you have to fight, right?
I do have to fight.
Okay.
And I ran away from my friend, which is unfortunate.
Oh, fuck me!
Yeah!
Okay, so the first army has Aunt Valdorf. It has a Archlector Balthazar Gelt, Aunt Valdorf, a melee specialist, Marcus Quate, a melee specialist, Ebon Keeper of the Dead, melee specialist, and Rutschel, Lord of Droners, missile specialist. It has five heroes, including their, you know, legendary Lord Archmage.
The second army also has many heroes.
Yeah, Volkar the Grim.
Three great goddamn wizards.
Two great cannons. It's got the rocket battery.
Just auto-resolve this bitch, because
we play this motherfucker. We play it deep.
Okay. Pay respects to the goat men. Yeah, Goro's heart render is about to have some very bad things happen to his face.
Yeah, he's pretty strong, to be fair.
Yeah, Goros is pretty strong, but this is too much, dude.
Mm, we'll see.
Like, these guys have purple cavalry. I don't even know what the hell purple cavalry do, but it's not good.
I could host it on my stream, to be honest.
You could.
Because I, as previously stated, did I tell you about applying for partner?
No.
I applied for partner on Twitch, and I sent them an email, and the email basically read, I'm not trying with Twitch, I basically play games I want to play, I could get viewers if I wanted to, but I can't be fucked because I'm concentrating on YouTube. Screw you guys, I'm just applying for partner because a couple of my viewers asked me to, have a nice day, peace out, dicks.
Nice.
Yeah.
Knowing my luck, you would get partner.
I mean, this is the thing, is it doesn't matter what I say, they're gonna partner me if they think I can make them money. So, yeah. You know, if they look at my YouTube and go like, yeah, his YouTube's doing quite well, he can, you know, in the future he can make money, they'll basically try and get me on side as soon as possible. Alright, we can't go over there. Okay,
I mean, we could...
Alright.
There's this hill in the forest to the right. We could go to the far left.
No, I mean, line. Attacking us. Here you go, line. Right here. Battle line, there.
Right where?
Red. Yeah. You use that rock to siphon them around the rock. So basically have two strong melee units on both sides of that rock, and they'll funnel around the rock, and you can kind of... It's not an amazing chokehold or anything, but it's better than other possibilities. And basically,
I'll tell you what. I'm going to give you the army, and you place them in a way that you think is wise.
Okay.
So I know what the hell you're talking about.
Right.
Because I have no idea what the hell you're talking about. Like, I see the rock, but I don't know what you mean. So, educate me, sheepdog.
Edumacate me. Edumacate. Oh, goddammit. Sorry. There we go. And then you guys go over here. Why aren't they hidden? That's so weird. Okay, so archers. Stop it. Archers, archers. Go. Archers, archers everywhere. Archers, archers, go right there. What's your strongest melee here?
A lot of my guys
here
can go outside this yellow box, so...
Spearherd. Possibly the spearherd. Yeah, spearherd, definitely. Okay, so we have a spearherd there. We have a spearherd there. And then you have the halberds here. And halberds here. And then you have the gore herds with shields here.
You can't use a giant boulder formation to build the super defensive fortifications against the army. Oh, goodness.
Okay, so then you have these guys here. And then these guys probably about here. What have we got left? We've got the best gore herd. Yeah, okay, we'll put them up here. Over here. And then we have the...
Basically, our only hope in this fight is to kill their heroes and hope their morale breaks, right?
I mean, it's one of the things. Okay, so, like, you're looking at this, right? Okay, so the best gore spear herds have the highest HP and armor and etc. Like, they're really good defensively. Mm-hmm. So what you want is you want them to come pretty much up this hill and, like, filter around the left and right of this rock, which will kind of, they'll go kind of column, which means your guys will fight them one, you know, like 1v1 a bit. Okay. Then you've got your defensive units, just move that back a little bit there. You've got your defensive units, you've got your gore herd shields on the right, you've got your halberds on the left. And then what you want to do is you basically want to engage them and run these dual-wielding bestgore herds and great weapon gore herds around the flanks and smack them in the flanks with those units.
Gotcha.
And then you've got like a few units at the back, like a bestgore herd and a gore herd halberds, just basically as not insurance, basically as reinforcements to your defensive line. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and draw off part of their army with the cavalry.
Right. Oh. Cool. Well, let's see how this goes.
Hell yeah.
The dogs support our actions.
That's good. Let loose the dogs of war.
Let loose the doggies of war. The troop count is very quickly turning against us.
Yeah.
You are losing ground.
I mean, okay, so this first army that's coming in, your pistoliers are going to be your main problem, so I'm actually probably going to engage the pistoliers.
Okay.
If I can. They are, however, moving a significant portion of their army out towards my guys.
Which is weird, because they shouldn't see your guys.
No, like, because they're fairly big, they stick out in the woods and that, so... But it has meant that they have a portion of their army running towards me instead of towards you, so that's good. You don't have anything that can take on the pistoliers, so you range battle the pistoliers, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Or... Or they'll charge in. Yeah, charge pistol ears on your left.
They're now charging away from me.
It's alright. Move your guys back.
You got more pistol ears coming in on you. Yeah. Now more pistoliers on me.
Yeah. I mean, like, this is the problem that's going to be amassing for us, is that the pistoliers going to do damage while at the same time being able to skirmish away. But they did charge in for some reason, so, yeah, melee them if you can.
Well, I mean, I'll try to melee them.
Yeah, when they run away, don't take the bait.
Fire! Fire on my everything! Ow.
I mean, the thing we want to do now is maximize maximize their casualties so that your next army can better deal with them, basically.
All right, I'm going to move my guys forward because they're just literally peppering me with spells and not ever engaging their dudes.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Engage their dudes if you can. How you doing,
guys,
bud?
Gets to going.
Oosh, that's a blob and a half, isn't it?
Yup. Go ahead. Replenish some hit points. Even though fortune gets damage resistance, great axe inventory.
Oof.
Oy. It's a hell of a blob. Send Goros to beat the crap out of their hero, though.
Yeah. unfortunately, your other army would be much more suited to this fight.
Yeah. It really would. That's fine.
Yeah.
Did their hero run away, or no? His flag is just behind mine.
Yeah. How you doing? I mean, the good thing, in a way, a little bit at least, about the blob, is you've got your hero's aura on you, you know?
Yeah, well, and it stopped them from continuing to use magic on me.
Yeah.
Like the big AoE pain in my ass magic.
Unfortunately, I'm fighting some Reichsguard, and yeah, Reichsguard are butts.
Beating the shit out of me.
Wow. Pretty sure there's an organ gun firing at us now.
Unpleasant.
Yeah. Most of my units are fleeing, unfortunately, at this point.
Yeah, I mean, we're in a... I've been a blob, and... I mean, people are dying on mass. So I'm just hoping that I can maybe kill their heroes.
Will help.
Yeah. Well, there's one down.
Got a missile specialist. He's a witch hunter. Witch hunters are assholes.
What if I can charge my way through his entire army to get to his witch hunter? Probably not.
I mean.
Just work your way through this blob, man. Just work your way through your blob and get over here to Volkmore the Grim.
Your Gorble probably could do it. Oh, you can get Marcus. Oh yeah, you can get these guys.
Yeah.
One of them's already running. Jesus, Chorus is hot. Is strong, isn't he?
Yeah, he's pretty strong.
If you can take Volkmar out, I heavily recommend it.
He's running away from me.
Yeah. They got some pretty strong units as well.
They really do.
Oh, like, and goddamn. They got the Knights of... Yeah.
Ow.
See that fucking penetration. God damn. Those Knights are so strong.
They really are. It's alright. I'm still chasing their heroes down and beating the crap out of the foot. Yeah. Dragons, my warriors, flee! No, don't flee!
No, don't flee. Please don't go.
Don't go. Everybody's now breaking. I mean, Goro's Heartrender is strong. I don't know if he's kill their entire team strong.
He's maybe kill a few heroes strong, though. Oh, no, he's gonna run. Yeah, I mean, that wasn't really another option. I bought boars! Like, three of them, but still I bought boars.
Nice. What sucks is Goros is gonna die here.
Not if everyone flees. If everyone flees, then
Goros is gonna die because we already retreated once.
Oh hell yeah! This is the danger of being a horde.
Yeah.
But I think we did quite well, to be honest. Like, considering...
Yeah, I think, honestly, I should have taken that first fight. I think with two armies, we may have had a chance to flip it.
But you can't tell, like...
The other option was just get this army completely destroyed by running.
Yeah.
It would have been better to... I don't know.
Yeah, I'm gonna...
Decisive defeat.
Typical goblin weapon, a great bouncing mouth that will eat anything it happens to land on. No subtlety to it, no innovation, no invention. Still, a crossbow bolt or two will kill it if you aim properly.
So he took my obsidian pendant.
Aww.